Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 6 of Project Infinity. Today I am joined with Swans on the server, and we did ourselves, like always, a bunch of awesome stuff between the episodes. I don't even know why I'm still saying this every time, because you guys know me, I like to do the most tedious amount of work and such off camera, because I know most of you guys aren't really interested in seeing that, but I do like to show off what I actually built and just make some, you know, interesting stuff on camera. So that's why I am standing right here quite far away from, well, where you guys would normally see me, right over there, like where my cursor is, not where my face is. And if you've looked on my minimap on the right, you would know that there is something new there, which is a marker called New Base. Yes. As we pretty much had like a big community building, at least up to this point, with shared resources and shared everything pretty much, it's time to for people to start, you know, thinking about their own bases a little bit, so we can split off just slightly and into our own houses and such, but still use the shared stuff in general. So that's pretty cool, and there is Swans just gliding everywhere. So yes, this is the new base that I have started building. As you guys can see, if I quickly fly up here, this is the main layout. I did quite a lot of work on the island to make it look like this, as it wasn't like originally an actual island, but just a bit of a branch off to this, and I still got loads of work to do. But this is the main idea that I had. So yeah, I definitely like it already, even though there's still a lot of work to do. As you can see, I'm kind of going with a bit of a modern team building, and I think that will look pretty nice. It's not something I've done before, so loads of marble, loads of basalt, and loads of mana glass. So it's really a bright area all around, so that's pretty awesome, I think. Then what I... pretty much got planned for this house is to use as my own personal, you know, well, house, like I said, but with a bit of a modern touch, as in a way of technology, because I would like to automate a lot of stuff in this house. So for example, I left two spots right here on either side because I would like to have computer craft touchscreen monitors right here. Pretty much having buttons like light switches to all rooms in this house, but also things like being able to control the doors that are going to be put in right here on these spots that I pretty much marked off. This is like the outside where we'll have like a little garden or whatever. One main big room right here with another touchscreen monitor to control everything on this floor at least. And then right here, another big main room. So yeah, that's pretty awesome. We'll also have things like probably applied energistics terminals like in the walls and loads of automation and control all in this fancy room in general. Then what I probably want to make is a sort of staircase coming like right there to around here, I think, in which I will be able to walk up here and have some sort of little balcony area. So imagine like this area. Like from there to right here, or maybe even also this square area, be like a little second floor balcony type deal. So a bit fenced off, nothing above it or anything. Just a bit of a place to hang out. And then the rest will be a second tier building on top of this thing. Make a little garden on top of the second floor, make a waterfall flow down somewhere on the side. Yeah, just all that kind of cool stuff. I got loads of things planned for this house and I definitely can't wait to get going on it. But sadly that requires a specific level of technology. For example, computer craft. Advanced computers require engineering presses, which require... we do have all the presses, but I believe inscribers are made a lot more expensive. As you can see, a resonant machine frame and... I mean, in theory, we can get most of this stuff already, but I think it might be just better to just wait off a little bit, start working on the main design of this building first, and then lay out all the fanciness later on. So yeah, that's pretty cool. And also things like applied energistics. Wait, what's this? Nuclear control? I have no idea what that is. But things like applied energistics network, Archmage, just a little bit more expensive than normally. As for the ME controller, you need enhanced Galgadorian metal, which is expensive as hell. Yeah, really expensive, apparently. And like quantum cores, so you need 4 nether stars for 1 ME controller. Like, what? Seriously? I make very big ME networks normally, like insanely large. And this is going to limit me a little bit, but I do think it will be quite cool. So if you guys have any suggestions on what you would like to see me put in this base, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. So yeah, let's get started on actually doing some stuff today, because, you know, I don't want to bore you guys too much to death with my building skills, and that's within quotation marks, the word skills. So yeah, I will be right back. Alright guys, so before I get onto my next adventure, there are still a couple of small things that I just want to show you guys that I did between the episodes. Which is, I made myself a new set of tools, pretty much all made with cobalt and tomium, including the hammer that I made, which also has manilium plates and a paper plate. But that's pretty cool, allows me to mine some stuff really fast. And I decided to change to the golden bag of holding instead of the normal bags that I had. Thank you very much for the person that suggested that in the comment section of my previous video. Awesome suggestion, almost completely forgot about these things. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So, there is something I definitely want to get today, which is by a request of a Enterprise, which is something he needs to make for his next tier blood magic thing, which is the eye. This thing, the Eldritch Eye. See, this is something you can, well, first of all, you can research it, but that requires some tainted research that I have not yet unlocked, even though I did do quite a lot of tainted research, like even the taboo golems and, you know, sinister stuff right here. A couple of those tainted things, but apparently my taint level is not high enough yet, so I'll have to see. But there is one other way you are able to get them, which is by killing Eldritch Guardians. And Eldritch Guardians are things that spawn near a monolith from, well, Tomcraft. Or at least there has a chance for them to spawn, which is one of these things. So I'm not sure if there's any prerequisites for this thing to actually spawn. I hope it's just a matter of me being around it. If not, I might have to wait for nighttime to do this and see if I will be able to slay a couple of them. So yeah, that might be something interesting to do. I'm not sure how many other ones I have found. Just looking on my waypoints, because I do think I have found multiple before. So let me see if I'm able to actually get a couple more of these. See if any of them spawn, and then, you know, do a little bit of, you know, killing. Alright guys, we're back. And today I brought myself a buddy. You Yudeldor bit me for now.
Yay!
Woohoo! So, yeah. Between the cut, I quickly got myself the thing that Enterprise requested me. Which is this thingy. I'm not gonna spoil it to you Yudeldor because he has to... I don't want to tell him because it's a secret for Enterprise. Shh, don't tell him.
Okay.
Yes.
Shh. I don't like secrets.
It's a good secret. It's something I told him was very difficult to get and might take a while, but... Well, it did take a while, but I did manage to get him for him. So,
so you'll get something good in return then?
I don't know. I hope. That's how karma works, I guess.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's the thing that I managed to get him from this location right here. Like, right behind our place is one of those thingies that actually makes sure that you can get that thing. I'm trying to talk as cryptic as possible, but yeah.
Mm.
If you guys that are watching don't understand what I'm talking about, don't worry about it. It doesn't really matter at all. And I quickly put some moss on my crossbow and crossbow bolts, as my bolts almost completely ran out. And, well, my crossbow doesn't really hurt if I put some regen on that either. So the thing that I want to do now is get myself some fortune on my, well, on my crossbow. Because that's, you know, just increases mob drops quite a lot. So the thing that I would like to get the fortune. Why are you standing so close to the other? What are you doing? You're making me nervous. No. What? What are you doing?
I'm innocent.
Okay. But pretty much I'm quickly going to the Nether to get myself some Nether lappies, as one piece of Nether lappies gives you, I believe, 24 lappies. So
yeah, 24.
Yeah, so that's what I have been doing for my, I believe it was my pickaxe or my hammer. No, my pickaxe. I still have to put something on my hammer, as I probably want to put silk touch on that thingy. But that requires a block of emeralds, so.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I could go to the village, get some emeralds.
Like in what way? Like killing the villagers?
No, trading them like wheat or something.
Oh. I guess that could work, but I will have to see.
You need the emeralds.
Well, yeah.
Cool. Yeah.
if you have nothing else to do, then sure. Hey, Arnite.
Not really. Oh, nice. See, now you find Arnite too.
Yeah, when I don't need it. Like 2 days ago, guys, when I want to make the parts for my tools, I needed the Arnite for Minalium. Couldn't find a single piece, and now I just keep finding it everywhere. Hey, more Arnite. Seriously, what is this?
Wow.
Like, I searched for like half an hour, couldn't find any. Yodelder was like, should I pop on and check? If you want, sure. Within 10 minutes, he finds over 10 pieces of Ardite.
Was it 10 minutes even?
Not even, I think. So, yeah, that's insane.
I was pretty lucky, though, you have to say. But still.
Yeah, precisely. But, you know, luck is important sometimes, I guess.
Hey, did you see the thing Swans is doing?
You mean his treehouse contraption? Or
yeah.
Yeah, I did see part of it. Looks pretty interesting, actually.
Yeah, he had the... what's it called? The thing which shows you, like... you can select spheres or cubes.
And the Builder's Guide, I think it is?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. He had that up and...
Oh, yeah, I saw that in your video, like, yeah.
Yeah, he's gonna make a half sphere. So, yeah, awesome. Something, I don't know. It looked completely amazing.
Yeah. For those who are wondering, Yodelder is getting back into the YouTubing business, or at least his new starting Let's Play. I'm hoping that's not a lie when I'm saying that.
I don't think it's a lie.
Cool. So be sure to check out my buddy Yodelder. As it's been a while since he, you know, managed to upload something, busy life and all. But I am extremely glad he's back, and not only can you guys now watch my side, but also his side for some stuff. So, that's awesome.
Yeah. You guys remember the crazy adventures from previous
Chance.
Videos, so.
Yeah. Right? Like, we played together on Resonant Rise, Fragrance Chance.
Loads of things.
Utopia Cubed.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot we also played on that. Oh, wow. We did a lot of stuff together, man.
Yeah, was some time ago.
Yeah, that's true. Like, the last time I remember playing on Utopia Cubed was around Halloween 2014, so.
Yeah, that's a while ago.
Yeah,
over a year. That's one of the things I really like about the expert recipe mode we have now.
Yeah, this...
Because it doesn't... Well, it takes a lot more before you actually, like, proceed with the mods.
Yeah, precisely. This is like something you can really play for like half a year, if not a lot longer. Who knows? And that's definitely something I like to do, because I've done multiple Let's Plays before, and, well, normally they don't last that long, so...
Yeah.
I would really like to get a more, you know, prolonged Let's Play going for a change.
Yeah.
Did I find some Nether Lappies here? I did. So yeah, let me quickly see if I can find some more lappies around here, and I will be back with you guys in a minute. Alrighty, folks, I managed to get myself a bunch of lappies and also some redstone while I was in the Nether, so that's pretty cool. We also have a Enterprise with us right now.
Hello.
So that's pretty awesome. So yeah, let's get what we need to get. Oh, and Yodelder was so kind enough to trade with a bunch of villagers to get me some emeralds. So yeah, that's awesome. That means I can finally get the tools that I need or want to make this. So let's see. For that, I need myself some string. Let's see, where do we have string? We have hemp.
We have infinite string.
Yeah, but I'm quickly looking up what the recipe is for the thing.
Yeah, 3 industrial hemp shapeless.
Yep, found it. There we go. Yeah, I think that's pretty much all I really need, I think. Oh wait, yeah, and a crafting table, of course. Assembly halo, crafting table. So I need 4 of these thingies. 4 silky cloths. And a block of emeralds. Then a recipe like this. And you get yourself 1 silky jewel. Awesome. Then what I need to do is quickly turn this lapis into blocks. So that will make it just a bit easier for me to actually use them. Also, yeah, I have a stack of lapis blocks right now. So that's just showing you guys how much lapis we have now.
Yeah, luck really helps for collecting stuff like that.
Oh no, I didn't use luck. I used I went to the Nether and got myself some Nether lapis, or like a lot of it.
Yeah,
that also helps.
Yeah,
you get 3 ore and you have a stack.
Yeah, exactly. So putting luck on my bow should have the effect that you want. That's kind of difficult with these bows and bolts. You have to know specifically what you need to put on. Wow.
Oops.
Well done, Enterprise. Wow. Blown up by a
creeper. Now you can sleep if you want, you elder.
Wow, how did you... Where did you get blown up?
Well, apparently there were 4 creepers there. Semi-hidden.
That's why you need to build a house. Desert
and there is quicksand there. I saw 1. And apparently there were more that were dying, but I came close to kill the 1 to get a shard, and they all blew.
Huh. Well, that's why you need to build a structure around it.
Well, no, I was hunting for mobs, because I need more blood shards.
Oh, that's a whole other story.
Yeah. So, note to self, don't go near quicksand when you're not sure of how many mobs are there.
So yeah, now I got myself some fortune tree or looting tree on my bow. Then I also wanted to put, let's see, silky jewel on this thing, which does take the speed down just a little bit, but well, it gives you silk touch. And then I'm just gonna fill it up with redstone all the way. I still already had moss on it, so. Yeah, there are.
I swear to God, I did not touch the thing.
Touch what thing?
Yes, you did.
The hammer.
Hammer time. Whoa.
We have a hammer?
I have a hammer.
Nice.
Now it has a speed of 11. There's still 1 more modifier, so let's put just a bit more on it. I have myself a very fancy set of tools. You should really see it, Enterprise. Yeah, why are you standing here?
I don't know, actually. I was gonna go up this thing. So, if I got it right, we need to build inside the Forest Hills biome, right?
Try to. You can, of course, build like on the edge or whatever, because the biome isn't that big, I think, but... You know.
Yeah, it's... kinda small, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, same like how I'm building, like, the coordinates I was given are kinda in the middle of a volcano.
So yeah, I would just say, like, build a little bit close, but, you know, not 3 biomes over, but, you know, if you stay within, like, a radius of a biome or something, I think it's cool. Just right. So we can, you know, be a little bit close to each other when needed. Mm-hmm, so we don't have to take trains to go to each other, pretty much. So yeah, now I got myself a mining speed 14.6 silk touch hammer. So
nice. Wood.
No cobalt, not wood. Yeah, bad joke, sorry. So okay, this thing is pretty fast. That's awesome.
Hey, and price the farms. Swans didn't touch the barrels, right? Upgrade them.
He said he would do that, so...
Oh, wow.
I assume he did that by now.
Guys, you can actually get to the inside of the... what's it called? The inside of the like hollow thingy right here. Just from the mining door. And it looks awesome inside. You should really check
the
it
hollow
out.
Hollow whaties?
Here.
Oh yeah, that. I know, that's how I got in there and lit it all up.
Oh. Well yeah, it looks awesome.
Little question, who keeps punching holes in the roof of this?
Enderman, of course.
Yeah, right. All those holes?
Yeah, I've had random places of dirt everywhere around my place too a few times. So.
Yeah.
That's a lot of dirt missing.
That's what you get
but
when...
Just a few Endermen.
That's what you get when you build a hollow place. When there's a hole, you instantly see it.
Yeah, clearly. Yep. Or you fall in it.
Yep.
Well, yeah. Blame the Enderman, I guess. So yeah. Pretty awesome.
We should get a floodgate and flood this entire area.
No. That's a shame.
Well, then the Enderman will stay away.
Well, yeah, but this is a cool location to build stuff in if needed.
We'll see. Yep.
We'll see. We'll see about that.
I think so, at least. But we'll see. Maybe...
Could be.
You know, if someone wants to build their house into that thing, you know, be my guest.
Hmm.
It's close to spawn.
I don't know, I'll probably build that structure that you suggested and make a room for myself in there.
Oh, mm-hmm. Come on.
Blood magic usually doesn't require that much resources.
True.
I see you went for the classic combination of marble and basalt, Kralj.
Yeah, I really did.
Looking
like,
pretty good. Getting nostalgic here.
Yeah, I know. Like, these things I absolutely love, and especially with my current resource pack that I'm using, they look just so clean altogether. Like,
yeah, you used the Faithful
32,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so,
I still didn't install that. I should.
Yeah, you really should if your computer can handle it. I mean, I'm currently recording at a stable above 60 frames per second. Okay, yeah, usually so. That's pretty awesome.
32 by 32 shouldn't be a problem.
No, precisely. And I just love the way this looks, just, you know, a bit more detailed. So
the old Red Power days, huh?
Yeah, exactly. So I already talked about to my audience like what I want to do with my base. So imagine like right here where you're standing, like this area right here.
Yeah,
would
these
be
two
like
rooms.
No, like the ceiling of this thing. Will be like a bit of a platform area where you'll be able to have like a little bit of a garden on top of it. And then the rest will be like a second tier house, whatever. So two tiers per part of it.
You're gonna have like grass growing on the roof.
Yeah, like part of it, like a little bit of a balcony type area. And then like a stairs from the outside, like on the left here or something that you can go up and all. I think it will look awesome.
I like it, yeah.
Yeah, me too.
It'll be pretty cool.
That's what I thought. So let's see, is there anything else that I would like to get done between the episodes, as I already showed you guys most of the stuff that I actually did this episode? I don't really think there's an awful lot still left to do. I mean, I didn't really think of, you know, making a lot of stuff this episode for you guys. Just pretty much just a bit of a casual, you know, let's talk, show you guys what I did episode. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed those episodes too. Be sure to let me know down in the comment section what you guys prefer. Like, either see me building, see me showcasing what I did, or just, you know, hanging out with these cool people like we have today, Udelda and the Enterprise, and just having a chat together about our nostalgic things about that we had in the past. So yeah, that's
the future, what we're going to build on the server.
Oh yeah, that too. Don't forget the future, because there's so much cool stuff we can build. But with that, guys, I think it would be a good wrapping up point. So yeah, like I said, be sure to let me know down in the comment section below if you have any feedback. I always read all the comments that I get. And if your feelings are just a bit more simple than that, feel free to hit that little thumbs up or thumbs down button. Feel free to stay up to date with all my news, updates and blogs with my website, also linked down in the description below. And with that, I'm gonna end up like usual. Thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.